Hello everyone, this is Shadow the Rat, and in this video I wanted to review the Haggen Living World Deluxe Habitat as a rat cage. So to start off, I want to go over some of the pros this cage has, and the first one I can think of is the fact that it has a very large top door. This means that it's very easy to access any part of the cage. It's also very easy to get your rats out right away. You can just open up the top of the cage and then reach inside, and you can easily access all parts of the cage, which is very nice when you're trying to clean or decorate the cage or just take out your rats. So the next pro I have is the fact that you have a very deep pan, and this is great if you're a bedding user like I am. One of the issues I have with my current cage, which is the Critter Nation, is the fact that the pan it comes with is way too shallow for bedding. That's not a problem with this cage though, because it has a very nice deep pan, easily keeps in the bedding. You can put in 2 or 3 inches and the rats aren't going to be able to get it out, which is just great if you want to use it like I am and you don't want to be cleaning up a mess every day. So the next thing I want to talk about is the fact that both of the doors on this cage are pretty secure, so there's no way the rats can get out. First of all, both of them lock in a way that requires a significant amount of pressure to open. The top door has these 2 little knobs that slide over the cage part, and this means that the rats aren't even able to access the locking mechanism. As for the smaller front door, it has a bar that slips behind the cage bars, which means there is no way the rats can get it open. I mean, I had difficulty getting it open, so there is no way they're getting out. Another nice thing about this cage is the fact that it comes with a built-in hideaway and food area. Now, in a way, this does make it a little bit difficult to access your rats if they are shy or timid and don't want to come out. However, I do find it nice that they have a little area that the rats can hide in, and that they also have a little level for the rats to have their food and water. This helps to discourage the rats from covering their food or water, and I was actually able to successfully use a bowl of water in this cage before. Now, if you're thinking about getting this cage for your rats, I recommend getting the large or deluxe version. I had the large version, and this can maybe fit 4 or 5 rats pretty comfortably. Now, the deluxe version, on the other hand, can apparently fit 6 or 7 rats according to the rat cage calculator I plugged the dimensions into. So both of these cages are pretty sizable. That means that the deluxe version is pretty much on par with the Critter Nation. That's really all I have in the pros section, and of course every cage has some downsides, so now I want to go over the cons of this cage. So one of my largest cons with this cage is the bar spacing. The bar spacing on this cage is 1 inch, and if you have younger rats or smaller rats, that just isn't going to work. Now, I had my rat Shadow in there, and she was a fairly large female, so that all worked really well. Then I got 2 baby rats, Latte and Blackberry, and both girls were 12 weeks old at the time, and both of them could slip through the bars. Now, Latte quickly outgrew the bars, and she wasn't able to slip through, but Blackberry could slip through them until she was like 9 months old, which means that I had to hardware cloth the cage. So I ended up hardware clothing it, and let me tell you, hardware clothing the roof, which is sloped, is a hassle. Hardware clothing any cage is difficult and is going to get you scratched up, but if you have a sloped surface, it's so much more difficult than if you just have the regular rectangles. So yeah, that's a big downside for me, but if you're willing to hardware cloth it, then it does work pretty well for rats of any age. Now, my next con is the fact that for some odd reason, and I really don't know why, they decided to add a checkered pattern to the pan. And this means that basically there's these little raised lines in a checkered pattern all across the bottom part of the pan that makes it extremely difficult to clean the pan well. And I just hate this. I don't know why they did that, and it doesn't really serve any purpose. All it does is make cleaning a lot harder when you're trying to make the pan nice and clean. Now, another issue I had with the cage is since the roof is basically your main door, anything you hang up there needs to be able to move with it. Like, you can't hang up anything with loose bedding involved because that's all going to fall out as soon as you open the cage. You also have to be careful if the rats are sleeping in it because, well, you can't open the cage door if they're sleeping in a hammock. They're just going to fall out. And I just didn't like the fact that everything I hung up, I had to be very careful with. Like, I couldn't hang anything on the ceiling and attach it to the sidebars because then I couldn't even open the cage, which kind of rendered it pointless. So the other issue I had with the doors is the fact that the small side door in front is just so dang tiny. I mean, that door can only support 1 hand going in, and this door is just not really functional. The other issue with it is the fact that locking it is so difficult. You have to push it behind the cage bars. There's this little bar that needs to snap behind the side cage bars, and when you push it, it requires so much force that it actually shakes the entire cage, and it's just difficult to push it in and pull it out every time. And I actually ended up not using the front door at all because it was just so difficult to use. So the other issue I had is the fact that this cage doesn't have any wheels. This means that if you're trying to move it around when it's full, it can be very difficult, especially if you're using a heavy pelleted bedding like I do. And I just think that wheels would have made moving this cage a lot easier, especially if you have the deluxe version. I mean, I just had the large version and I already had enough issues moving it around, so I can't imagine what it would be like if it was larger. So my final con is the fact that this cage is just very easy to chew or break. I mean, it's completely made out of plastic except for the wire bars, and because of that, if your rats ever get into a chewing mindset, they can pretty easily make a hole into the bottom of the cage. Then there's also the fact that most of the attachment parts are done with little plastic clips, and these are super easy to break. So you kind of need to be careful when assembling the cage and moving it around. And also, if you have rats who like to chew, you just need to watch them to make sure they're not chewing on the base of the pan because, well, if they chew enough, they could definitely escape. Okay, so that's basically all I have for you today, and I hope it was helpful. If you guys would like any more rat care tips or rat trick training tips, feel free to visit my website at www.rattricks.weebly.com, link in the description. Other than that, I hope you have a wonderful day, and hope to see you next time. Bye!